Sup, Flex Video. This is Michael Liberatore shooting a chess video down at Quads North on the north side of the city of Chicago, Memorial Day weekend. Started off a little bit today with some incline hammer strength, single arm. I like doing this because I can kind of tweak the movement. I can turn into it, feel a little bit more squeeze on the inner and the upper part of my chest because that's the area that I need more development. I find that when I do standard incline, especially two-handed, which is most exercises, I get more on the outside, and I'm not feeling enough where I need it, and that's on the inner and upper part of my chest. So this first exercise here, you can see the way I turn in and where the chest is actually contracting. It's putting a lot of tension on the inner part of my chest, and not that I'm not hitting the outer part. I mean, there's still a little bit there, but I'm really trying to concentrate and get that mind-muscle connection on the inside part to help build that chest up. So I get, you know, more compliments on bringing my chest up and being fuller and bigger. From there, next exercise, I move to an incline fly. This is a great exercise too for the inner part of my chest. The way I do it is I really try to take a deep breath and expand my chest cavity, and I open up so that I could get a deep stretch. And if you notice, my arms are kind of bent, probably a little bit more than average. This allows the same thing. I feel a little bit more of a stretch and a contraction on the inner part of my chest and the upper part of my chest. If I straighten my arms a little bit more, I'll feel it more on the outside, and that's just, you know, for me. Everybody's a little different in their body mechanics, so for me, I feel it a little bit more on the inner part when my arms are bent. It also, I feel a little safer going heavier this way, that I'm not going to tear a pec or something like that. You start getting up 90, 100, 110s on flies, that's a lot of weight, and a lot of times what I'll do is I'll try to do a little bit more volume instead of keep moving up the weight, because once you pop something or tear something, it's never going to be right. From there, we move back into the hammer strength room, and I got lucky today being down here at Quads. I had this flat hammer strength ISO. You could do both sides independently. I get a great pump and a great squeeze out of this. Same thing as before. I kind of take a deep breath and I arch the upper part of my back, or I kind of pinch my shoulder blades together so that I can really get a good stretch in my chest and get my elbows down deep. And when I press, I'm pressing with the inside part of my hands. I'm not trying to use my triceps or my shoulders, and I'm driving through with the palms of my hands and really trying to squeeze. This is a great exercise because it just, for pumping and for a volume trainer like myself, puts a lot of blood into the chest. And you can see a lot of the exercises I do really is about putting more blood in the chest, bringing the, you know, the vitamins and the nutrients and the oxygen and everything to that muscle. I mean, that's why we do it. We do it for the pump, or at least why I like to train. I love that pump, and it makes you look bigger and full and hard, especially when you pose at the end. Everybody kind of has their own little Mr. Olympia look after they get done training. And at the end, we moved back to a single arm. You notice I do a lot of independent stuff. That's because I feel that when you're training with two hands or two feet or whatever it is, sometimes you will lean towards your strong side, and you'll let that stronger muscle take over, or the more coordinated muscle to take over and do most of the work, and you'll get some sort of deficiencies. You know, I noticed I had one of my quads starting to go away because I've been training the last couple years doing a lot more single leg press. So here, doing a single arm seated fly, I can kind of go past the center too, so I get a better contraction. If you do two, you kind of stop in the center. Well, there's a little bit extra momentum or movement that you can do to finish off the exercise by going past, you know, the center, so it contracts a little harder. And like I said before, it forces the area that's weaker, which I don't know. I think this is probably my right pec is not quite as full as my left, so it really gives me a chance to focus on that right pec so that it can, you know, get a little bit closer to the left one. You know, I really believe that, you know, you should do some independent training or ISO training. You know, it incorporates a lot more muscles. You can't use your core, and you can't cheat as much. A lot of times when you're doing, you know, two hands or two legs, you know, you can bite your teeth and grind or, you know, buckle down and bust out a couple more reps, you know, using recruiting other muscles to push that weight up. So when you're doing one at a time, you really can't do that, and you can't cheat as much. So this is a little bit of a chest workout for me. I might have usually done one or two different exercises, or maybe one more exercise, but it is Monday morning, Memorial Day, and you know, threw this together last second, and you know, now after this, got to get out of here, go eat, do the things with the family, and try to grow. And it's a good workout down at Quads. It's always good to come down here, and you know, hopefully with some more workouts like this, you know, I'll get back up on the stage soon. I'm not sure when. Might be at the end of this year. Off season's going pretty well. Been training pretty hard. Been training with, you know, Mr. 187, if everybody knows who that is. Mel Chancey's been pushing me pretty hard and keeping me honest. And so when I come back on stage, I, you know, show the judges what they want and make them happy. So definitely we'll do some more videos here for Flex, and you'll be hopefully seeing those improvements, and I'll be bringing some of my knowledge to the table. So, you know, anybody who's out there, you can get a hold of me on Facebook or mcmusclepros@gmail.com. Any questions about, you know, workouts, nutrition, diet, any of that stuff, I'd be glad to share. It's great, you know, being able to do this video on Flex and show people the reasons why we do things. You know, sometimes the pros, you know, we got a little bit, you know, we got some secrets, so, you know, that we steal from one another. And these are just a couple of the things that I do, and I'm glad I got to share it with you. So, everybody, I hope you had a good Memorial Day weekend, and I'm out.